All right, here we go. The first car out in the number 56. It's the Flying Veteran. It's going to be David Earl Gentry. And coming up behind him, making his first start with the Southern All-Star since Milton, Florida, it's Jim Gray, one of the local heroes here at the Speedway. So green flags out for super late model qualifying, group number one. So David Gentry hits the loud pedal and runs it down the back stretch with Jim Gray also in tow. 13.398 for David Earl Gentry on lap number one. Jim Gray comes out of turn four. He hits the straight. 13.834 for him. Very close laps between the two. 13.071 for David Earl Gentry on lap number two and out of turn four. Jimbo Gray, he picks it up to a 13.803 on his second go around. So David Earl Gentry, the fastest of the first group, with a 13.071 so far. Next machine out in the number 54 is the Raging Redneck out of Mississippi. It's David Brazell. And behind him in the F-Zero machine, finished sixth with the Ray Cook Southern National Series, it's going to be Farrell Skelton of Mount Pleasant, Tennessee. David Brazell to the top of the board, a 12.634 on lap number one. Skelton, he lights it up out of four. 12.98 on his second first round. Picking it up on lap two, the Raging Redneck goes to a 12.519 on lap number two. Skelton getting loose off four, he hangs it in there. 13.301 for Farrell Skelton. Next machine out in the Rocket XR1 Wood Motorsports entry, the leader of the Southern All-Star Series points in rookie year chase. It is the JYD of Austin Horton, and coming up behind him, running the East Tennessee Vipers, striking down here in Middle Tennessee, sitting third in the ultimate points, it'll be Jason Welshin. So lap number one for Mr. Horton, second quick with a 12.603. Welsh in third quick with a 12.732. Horton just a tick slower on lap number two to a 12.643. Welsh in not quite picking it up to a 12.765 on lap two as he goes third quick. Next machine out in the number 85. It'll be Mitch Thornton, and behind him in the D3 machine, it's going to be Dickie Michael. So two of the local heroes time trialing here at the Speedway as they're making their second appearance of the season. So lap number one, Mitch Thornton, a 12.899, going fourth quick so far. Dickie Michael, he crossed the stripe for lap one. 15.572. Mitch Thornton slows down to a 13.218 on lap two. So Dickie Michael comes out of four. 14.297 for Dickie Michael. Track starting to get a little bit on the dry slick side. So the next driver out of Moultrie, Georgia, sitting second in the Rookie of the Year and overall points chase, it's the Moultrie Madman of Tristan Seeley. And behind him, in the number 17, one of our Alabama boys, making his second appearance here at the Thunderhill Raceway Park, is Big Bad Billy Franklin. Tristan Seeley, second quick with a 12.605 on lap number one. Billy Franklin, seventh quick with a 13.060. 12.952 for Tristan Seeley, but he's still second quick overall. Billy Franklin picking it up on lap number two to a 13.020. So Tristan Seeley up to second with a 12.605. So that leaves us one more driver here for group number one in the 54 machine out of Lakeland, Tennessee. Your July 8th winner here at Thunderhill Raceway Park. It'll be Double D Dane Dakis. Sasker coming off there in turns three and four. Lap number one for Dane Dakis. How about that? He goes fourth quick with a 12.649. Dakis doing it hard out of four. 12.686 on lap number two for Dane Dakis. All right, first machine out in the J8 machine is going to be Mr. Jaden Frame making his fourth start with the Southern All-Stars here this season. Next machine behind him, sitting third in the Southern All-Star Series points out of Hohenwald, Tennessee, is Easy Eric Hickerson. So coming out of turn four, Jaden Frame likes it down to the bottom. He comes out 12.621, a good lap for him and Hickerson. Riding high, wide, and handsome all four. He goes to the top of the board with a 12.602. Frame a 12.785 on his second go around. Hickerson comes back by even faster on lap number two with a 12.562 on his second go around. So already fast laps getting laid down here in the second group. Next machine out into number 83. It'll be Jason Walker, and behind him, Indio number 20, it'll be Mr. Ray McElhiney. So Walker works it off four. 13.745 on lap number one for Walker, and out of four, McElhiney, he hits the strike. 13.227, and caution out for the 83 machine of Jason Walker. So McElhiney, he's gonna get his final go around it as he comes out of four. .1397 for Ray McElhiney on that second go round. Faster lap for him as he's third quick. Bump qualifying will commence after these final two cars hit the stripe of who will be the top five locked in to the 10 cars. Automatic locked in on the top five rows. Next machine out of Augusta, Georgia, in the 01 machine is Little Lightning Jack Travis Pennington. And behind him in the 212 machine, living it way up there on turn four, it'll be the 212 machine of Josh Putnam. Travis Pennington, a 12.677 on lap number one. Putnam brings in with a 12.818. And Travis Pennington, a 12.953 on lap number two. Putnam got a better line working on four. Picks it up to a 12.689 on lap two. Next machine out in the number 11 machine is gonna be James Neal, and behind him in the 17R, runner up and DirtOnDirt.com cruise with the champions, Rookie of the Year, Mr. Midnight Brad Skinner. So James Neal clocks in with a 14.039 on his first go around. Skinner, fifth quick, 12.993 on this go around. James Neal goes up to seventh with a 13.461. Skinner really high, wide, and handsome. Remains fifth quick with a 12.690. So now we're down to two. Next machine on the C66 is going to be Mr. Donald Johns. And coming up behind him in the number 25, the 25-year-old young talent driver of Joseph Faulkner. He'll be coming out. So Joseph Faulkner has collected into the turns one wall, and that will kill his night. Hopefully not too bad. It was a nice lick. He was trying to get the car back straight off turn four, and that's what kind of left a long trail of trying to get back and didn't quite work out right.